that's good. We could, you want to try to just play it?
Okay.
So we were on tour a couple weeks ago, and we were listening to Kendrick Lamar's full discography all the way through. And the album that still resonates with us the most, I think, is Good Kid, Mad City. We found out that it actually came out on October 22nd. And we had the crazy idea of making kind of like an ode to Kendrick Lamar from the songs on Good Kid, Mad City. Most of the songs on the project have a really amazing, healthy relationship of jazz and hip hop in there.
I think that you did it right.
Yeah. It's pretty easy for us as jazz musicians turned hip hop producers to go into the studio with all of our friends and make some magic happen based on what Kendrick did back in 2012.
Like, so everything, all the tempo changes happen immediately and not gradually, so we can actually like record shit to this and it'll all line up, right? Instead of giving you a horn stem and then giving you a stem with like the tracks and the Moog stuff, I'm gonna give you a horn plus Moog effects plus like everything that I, basically like, stuff that I already did, stuff that Kendrick Lamar did. Okay. That's what you're getting. Right. Two things.
Yeah, man.
Me, Kendrick.
We realized that we didn't have much time, so we got the musicians together as fast as we could, booked a studio as fast as we could.
Two,
just got it all together.
Four.
I used to listen to Good Kid, Mad City at the gym, walking around New York City. It just got me through my days. Such a good album.
Woo! That's great. I thought that you were going to come in with tom fill or come in with a kick drum, but it was perfect leaving it empty.
This was honestly just fun for us. If anybody else really digs it, Kendrick hears it, something crazy, you know, that's just a bonus. Because this was an amazing project for us to do. And we will do it again, probably with another artist and another album. But for now, here is Good Kid, Brass City.